We're talking about a compromise, talking about common ground. One compromise you don't agree with, this Iran deal that was passed today, or agreed upon today, right. I should say. You were very critical. You said this deal is could be a death sentence for Israel, which
yeah,
is obviously
pretty critical.
That's very critical. It's very strong wording. Now, why are you so upset about the terms of this deal? Because it seems to me that based on what we are hearing, Iran is very close to having the ability to create a nuclear bomb. This puts that off for 15 years. This brings in more inspectors, things that it seems to me are good things as far as keeping it away from them. Why such strong words?
Well, when the Iranians say this is a win-win, it probably is not.
Mm-hmm.
So the bottom line, the goal was to dismantle their program, which is a good goal, to avoid a war, which is a great goal, to find a diplomatic solution to nuclear ambitions. Instead of dismantling the program, we have ensured they will become a nuclear nation. We're giving them $18 billion, and they haven't changed their behavior at all, and there's no requirement to do it. We're lifting the arms embargo on the most radical regime in the region. Other than that, this is a good deal.
Now, a lot of the criticisms of this negotiation is that this is what America wanted when they sat down at the table, and
right.
they didn't get all of it. Part of negotiation, obviously, is finding this middle ground we were talking
right.
about. You have to give it a little bit. It seems to me, you know, what are you saying that there's nothing to negotiation, or did you expect to sit down and have Iran say, you know what, all your terms
right.
we're good with?
Here's what I wanted to have happen. I wanted a deal that would not make the Arabs feel like they need to get a nuclear weapon. Now you've locked in an industrial-sized Iranian enrichment program that can become a nuclear program by the sheer passage of time. You're giving them billions of dollars without requiring them to change their behavior. You're lifting an arms embargo to the most destructive regime in the region. You're going to, in the name of trying to find common ground, which we've talked about me, create a nuclear arms race in the Mideast. I wish it were a good deal. At the end of the day, if I were president, I'd tell the Iranians the following. You're not going to get a penny until you stop destabilizing the Mideast, wreaking havoc on your neighbors. You're never going to get the arms embargo lifted until you change your behavior, renounce terrorism. And when it comes to a nuclear program, you can have a peaceful power program, peaceful nuclear power program. But if you want a weapon, you're not going to get it. If you want a war, you're going to lose it.
Well, here's the thing. I think if we make them wait 15 years, that in 15 years, there's just going to be like an app on your iPhone that stops nuclear bombs. So
well,
I
hope so. You know, I hadn't thought about that. Maybe you're right.
All right. Well, thank you so much for being
thank
here.
Thank you.
And I really hope you get on stage. It'd be nice to see you at the debate.
Thank you.
Senator Lindsey Graham, everyone. We'll be right back.